The unbeaten Hurricanes looked as dominant as they have all year in shutting down the number 3 team in the country and having fun doing it. They're going to need to buy more turnover chains. One for you, and one for you, and another for you. In the first half of Saturday night's 41-8 Miami win alone, Notre Dame threw 3 interceptions. The first yielded a Miami touchdown, the second a field goal. Fighting Irish coach Brian Kelly yanked starting quarterback Brandon Wimbush after that with little effect, except perhaps to eliminate even the question of whether Miami would keep scoring. Backup quarterback Ian Book tossed a pick 6 on his second possession. All of them were rewarded with the golden bling that has become college football's most beloved celebration. That was the story of the night, although Miami by no means did all of its damage on defense. In each phase of the game, the Hurricanes were the superior team, unrelenting from the opening kickoff. Going into the game, Notre Dame's offense was averaging nearly 500 yards per game, ranked No. 13 among FBS teams this season. But Miami had its attack figured out, whether it was Wimbush, who returned in the third quarter, or Book under center. Running back Josh Adams, who played only a quarter last week against Wake Forest due to an unspecified ailment which involved headaches but not the concussion protocol, was back against Miami, but he spent time in the third quarter in the medical tent and did not return. Whether it was his health or Miami's defense, the likely explanation is both. Adams wasn't himself, averaging just 2.5 yards per carry on 16 rushes. Going into the game, Adams had been good for an average of more than 100 yards, carrying the offense on multiple occasions throughout the Irish's 8-1 start. Without him to anchor the unit on Saturday, Notre Dame looked lost, racking up just 261 yards and struggling to find any balance on offense.